This is Matt.
This is Katy.
This is Grommet.
And this is Grommet. Grommet had some surgery today, and she's
had to wear the cone of shame.
She's feeling all, I need my human, so she's going to be in this video. Welcome back to those of you who, of our 15 viewers, subscribers, if you're watching this, thank you again. We appreciate your support. If you're new to the channel, please remember to subscribe, click the like, share, all of that fun YouTube stuff. And with that being said,
roll that beautiful footage.
So, you two need a little help. I will give you the best possible chance of getting pregnant. How does that sound?
That sounds great. Am I going to be one of those women who has it all? My career, or my kids, my old man by my side?
What are you calling old? You are 100% pregnant.
Welcome to the family.
So tonight we want to talk to you about False Positive. This is a movie that's currently streaming on Hulu. It stars Justin Theroux, Pierce Brosnan,
Ilana Glazer,
and a couple other not familiar faces, but very good actors. Ilana Glazer and Justin Theroux play a couple that have desperately been trying to get pregnant for years. Justin Theroux has an idea to go to a doctor friend of his who specializes in fertility.
He's also a doctor.
He's also, right, Justin Theroux is a doctor. They go to this fertility doctor and wham, she is pregnant right off the bat. And that's all I'm going to tell you because the story progresses from there and I don't want to give anything away. Grommet, what did you think?
She did not like it because it was very loud.
Yeah. Katy, what did you think?
Okay, so it's no secret from the trailer that this is kind of a modernized version of Rosemary's Baby. It's mm-hmm. not that situation, but it's that kind of idea. Overall, I liked it. I feel like it was solid. I liked the story. I did have some issues with it because there are very few perfect movies, but mostly everything, every single scene to me felt off. Felt like something was just off from the very beginning, every moment. And there were these obvious little, when they go to the fertility clinic, the nurses are in these very 1950s pink low-heeled outfits with their, you know, there were just certain, and they were just so way too Stepford Wives chipper, and it just, everything just kind of felt artificial, even in places where, for she is a, she's an advertising, and there are a couple scenes with her and her boss and her coworkers. And even when it turns out that they are actually, like, good guys rooting for her, happy for her happiness, it just feels false. It feels like it's put on to me.
I get that.
I think it was just a directorial choice. I think it was pauses and camera shots. There were just, I just was on edge the entire time. But I liked it. I thought it was a good movie. I just felt
I got that same feeling, but only when they were in the fertility office, or when she was talking. She actually, at one point, she meets with another group of women.
She goes to a mommy kind of
like a mommy group for women with
who've struggled with fertility.
Right, and that's the only time I got that feeling, which I thought was on purpose.
And see, that was the only time that I felt almost normal.
Really?
It was the only time that it felt almost normal to me is when the women were there together.
Okay. Okay.
I think it was a choice. I think it was on purpose. But there's a lot of commentary in this about power and women's roles and expectations and
specifically, I think women's
ownership.
Roles during Well, maybe not during the pregnancy. Maybe overall women's roles. Yeah.
That idea that that's kind of what you're here for.
Yeah.
And a little bit of pushback against that and an acceptance of that. And
yeah.
What does that do to the rest of your life? And, you know.
Twist your face.
Okay.
Pretty funny twist your handle.
I liked it. I didn't love it, but I liked it. I thought the acting was great. I thought Pierce Brosnan was really good in this one. I really had fun watching him. He was the standout to me.
Yeah.
I was impressed with Ilana Glazer. The only stuff I've seen her do up until this was comedy, Broad City, and some of the stuff she showed up in movies. So it was really good to see her tackle a more serious role, and I think she did a good job.
She did. I wanted less... There were a lot of close-ups just on her face and her facial expressions, and that got old because there were times that it just felt like, okay, we know what she looks like, and she's not doing anything special here. Can we stop with these moments?
But I enjoyed it. I thought it was a decent watch. I would definitely suggest it. If anybody asked me if there was something kind of creepy, thrillery to watch, I would say, yeah, give this one a shot. I would tell you, if you are currently pregnant or thinking of getting pregnant, probably don't watch this one.
No, don't.
I would wait until after you have the kids and you've decided you're going to keep them for permanent. Then it's probably okay to watch it.
If you are. And if you're not, whatever.
One thing that did stand out to me that I wanted to mention was the score. It starts out when they're in this period of trying to get pregnant and the fantasy of having kids and being a family. The music has this very whimsical, happy kind of feel to it, but as it goes on through the film and we get deeper into what's happening and the evil plan starts to come, it gets darker. And I really appreciated that. I really enjoyed the final bit of music towards the end. It was it was really kind of cool the way they slipped that in there, and it was not... Well, I don't know what the song was supposed to be about, but it fit perfectly for making the final kind of confrontation that much creepier. Final thoughts.
Final thoughts are, trust your instincts. Don't let anyone else tell you what the truth is. Don't let anyone talk you into something that just doesn't feel right to you, no matter what that thing is. Gromit would really like to know what your final thoughts are before she falls asleep.
My final thoughts are, I think pregnancy is a great setting for horror. It creeps me out. Not the idea, the idea of having kids kind of creeps me out. But the whole physical science behind pregnancy really kind of creeps me out. So, not that there's anything wrong with it. If you're pregnant right now or you have kids, I think it's beautiful, more power to you. It's just not for us. And as a person who has watched a lot of horror films in his days, pregnancy is a perfect setting for a horror movie. There you go. All right. So, with that being said, we're going to let you guys go. Once again, please subscribe, click the like button, share, tell your friends about us, comment, let us know if there's any movies you'd like to get our thoughts on, and we're gonna let you go. You guys have a good night. We're gonna put this one to bed before she falls asleep here. Good night, guys.
Bye.